out here always trying to act up when I'm trying to make a video. I'm like, girl, please. Hey YouTube fam, it's your girl Kaisha here, back with another video. And this video is all about my journey since I've graduated from the American Musical and Dramatic Academy. Today marks 1 year since I graduated from the school, so I thought I'd make a video all about my journey 1 year after graduation. You guys responded really well to the video that I made about my experience at AMDA, so I thought you might be interested in hearing how my journey has been 1 year after graduation. So we got some stuff to talk about, so let's go ahead and let's jump right into it. For those of you that don't know me or maybe new around here to my channel, my name is Kaisha S. Huguley. I'm an actress, entrepreneur, creator, and educator. I quit my full-time job with the federal government in 2017 to pursue musical theater at the American Musical and Dramatic Academy. I started the conservatory program in June of 2017 and I graduated in September 2018. So I have shared in another video all about my experiences at the school. However, today's video is about my experiences 1 year after AMDA. So, after AMDA, how do I even attack this? It's been a whole year. I actually can't believe it's been a year. That year has flown by. I mean, to be honest, being at AMDA, that flew by, so this year after has definitely followed suit. So when you are in the conservatory program at the American Musical and Dramatic Academy, you are allowed to audition in your fourth semester. In your fourth semester, you have all day to audition, and classes start at night. They start at 5:30, so you have the entire day to go out and do auditions and to really, you know, get yourself acclimated to the audition scene. So when I was at AMDA during my fourth semester, which would have started in July of 2018, I started auditioning and I hit the ground running. The first day, it had to be almost the first day of fourth semester where I literally went out on an audition and I was like, okay, let's go, let's do this. It's my mantras, there we go, the mantras that I do in the morning. I've been doing that all morning because I'm heading to my first audition in New York. New York is a very competitive market. And throughout my final semester at the school, I auditioned regularly. If I'm remembering the numbers correctly, I did something like 26 to like 36, something like that, auditions in my fourth semester. And I like really went hard because I was like, yo, I want to be booked. In my head, I was like, I will have a job lined up for the day after graduation. I graduated on September 29th, September 30th, I needed to be starting a contract. That's how simple it was for me. So once I got into the audition process, I realized very quickly that that may not be my reality because it was a lot more competitive than I could have even imagined. And I said, oh my, this is actually, ooh, wow, ah, it's 5 million people out here and so am I. So the reality of how competitive the industry is really hit me, you know, during my fourth semester. Probably about 200 equity members that came out, and so they decided not to see non-equity actors, so I didn't get seen today. And basically, I was able to leave my headshot. So there's a little bit of a school of thought, or this is what I personally think. Was it a waste of my time? Never, because I learned something. And whenever you learn something, it's never a waste of your time. And I left my headshot. Is it likely that they'll look through the whole stack of headshots? I don't know, but there's a possibility. And whenever there's a possibility, there's an opportunity. So here comes graduation. And at graduation, I didn't have a job lined up and I was getting ready to, you know, walk across that stage and I had no plan of what I was doing. So just a little history on me. I went to Mount St. Mary's University for my bachelor's degree and I also went to George Mason University for my master's degree. When I graduated from both of those institutions, and even if we go back to high school, when I go back to those institutions, when I graduated, I had a plan for what I would do as soon as I got out of school. This is the first time in my life at that point, I was 28. I guess I'm still 28 right now. I'll be 29 in a couple of weeks. But anyway, this is the first time in my life technically I was 27 because my birthday wouldn't happen yet. Anyway, at 27 years old, that was the first time that I literally did not know what I was going to do after graduating from an academic institution. I literally was like, I don't have a job. And not only did I not have a job, like a acting job, I didn't have a survival job at the time. So I was like, yo, what am I about to do for real? So September comes and goes pretty much because it was the end of the month when we graduated. So we come into October. October was my birthday month, or October is my birthday month, and Halloween is in October, so that kind of distracted me a little bit. I continued to audition, but I spent some time, you know, just celebrating and like really enjoying that moment. my husband and I were still long distance at the time, so I was definitely still doing a lot of travel. I think in October, I spent maybe 2 weeks at home. I spent 2 weeks at home in November and in December as well for the holidays. I just really needed to be out of the city and to give myself a break. So I did audition actively during those times, but it wasn't as much as it had been when I was in my fourth semester. So somewhere between, you know, September and December, your girl fell into what I'll call just a minor case of, like, I am really, really sad. I was so sad, guys. Sad was not even, I don't even know if that's the word to describe it, but I was real sad. And I just didn't know what I was doing. I was like, oh my God, what do I do? Now, when I was in my fourth semester, simultaneously with auditioning, I was rebuilding my business. I had a business called Kai Hudson Company, LLC, that I started in 2016 that I put entirely on hold when I was at AMDA. And so I said, when I got in my fourth semester, I was gonna start bringing that back, which I did. And as I started to bring that business back, it morphed into a new and different business with a new mission. My first business was all about women's empowerment and things like that, and like mastermind groups and all that kind of thing. And I was keeping some of that same model in my new business, but I renamed my business to Kaisha Creates LLC. I changed all of my branding on social media, and so that's why I am known as Kaisha Creates. If you watch any of my older videos on this channel, you will see me refer to myself as Kai Hugs, because that was my brand name, you know, when I had my other business. And so since then I have upgraded and we are now Kaisha Creates. So yeah, I started that business towards the end of the year. I, you know, thought about new programming and new content that I wanted to put out there. And, you know, I really was taking, you know, some pretty preliminary steps with that. But then I was like, no, like I really want to like dive all in. Again, I was still auditioning, but nothing was coming back. And I was getting really frustrated and discouraged with that. So I said, you know what, let me start some kind of creative project that will distract me until I book an opportunity. So I was like, okay, the opportunities aren't coming right now. I'm going to create my own opportunities. And I didn't know what they were going to be. I just knew that I was going to create something. Hence, Kaisha Creates was born. I definitely feel like I'm that person that is always interested in, you know, multiple things. So I said, you know what, let's just create something and let's have fun while we do it. One of the number one compliments that I get from a lot of people is that I have really, really great stories. So I decided to start a podcast, and I called that podcast A Kaisha Story. You know, like A Christmas Story. A Christmas Story is one of my favorite Christmas movies. So I was like, ooh, I can call it A Kaisha Story. And so A Kaisha Story was born. And I started doing the planning towards the end of 2018 for this podcast. And I said, okay, I need to figure out, you know, like what equipment do I need? I didn't want to spend a whole bunch of money. I was just like, I want to, you know, just go ahead and get this thing started, start telling these stories and produce one season of episodes. And then I'll go from there. So as I started working on this, again, I continue to audition. I'm still traveling backwards and forwards to see my husband, you know, in DC, because we're still doing the long distance marriage thing. And in February, I got a call that I booked my first off-Broadway musical called Revelation. And so I was like, yo, yo, yo. I was so excited, guys. They don't have an Oh, well, thank you so much. I really appreciate that. And I'm really looking forward to being a part of this great project. Sure. Sure, absolutely. Oh, thank you so much. I'm looking forward to working with you both. All right. All right, talk to you soon. Bye. I booked it. Oh my God. That was my first professional paying gig in the city. Oh, let me not forget. So before I got my first professional paying gig, what I did was I did two cabarets. When you do cabarets in New York, you have to sell tickets to get people to come to the cabarets. And unfortunately, I couldn't get my tickets sold for like both that I did. So my family, even though they couldn't come to see me in person for either one of them, because they were so quick the way that it happened. I had one like October like 16th and another one was like right at like the next week later. So they weren't able to come. So what they did was they Venmo'd me money to purchase the ticket, even though they weren't able to attend. So then I didn't have to pay for those ticket fees. So I ended up doing two cabarets. If you guys want to talk more about, you know, like my cabaret experience, I'd be happy to do that in a separate video. However, that's what I did there. And then after that, I did a play called 12 Angry Women with a group of, I guess it was 12 of us, 12 angry girls. No, we weren't all angry, but yes, it was called 12 Angry Women. And that was a play. I hadn't done a play in a really long time. So that was actually a lot of fun. And I enjoyed doing that. And that was at the Sonnet Theater on 44th. So those were the first three things that I did. As soon as I got out of school, I started doing cabarets and I did that play. The play was unpaid. It wasn't something that I was receiving payment for, but it was a really good experience that I personally had. So here we go, fast forward back to 2019. In 2019, opened up the new year. Oh, actually, what did I do? Okay, so when did this happen? So at the end of 20, what was it? At the end of 20, can I talk? At the end of 2018, I went to Atlanta. Was it Atlanta? Oh my gosh, why am I blanking on this? Y'all, I legit can't remember where this conference was, but there's a conference that I've been doing every year for like the past 4 or 5 years where I go to this annual winter meeting with the African Methodist Episcopal Zion Church. And literally I went to that at the end of the year and I did like 4 days, you know, with a bunch of you from all around the country that are part of this denomination. And we work together, produce a drama presentation so that they would be able to present that in the youth night. And so during that time, I also remember being very sad. I was still very sad because I've been auditioning so much. At that point, probably by the end of December, I had done at least, I don't know, maybe 50, 60 auditions, and I just felt like I was hitting a wall and nothing was happening. And so here we are in January 2019. At the top of the year, I said, okay, like I need to re-strategize about how I'm approaching auditioning, and I need to be really, really smart and strategic because I'm going out to all of these auditions. I have been a very lucky performer in that as a non-union performer, I haven't run into walls too much where I haven't been seen. I can count on my hand how many times I haven't been seen. And for me to have been to so many different auditions, I think that's really, really good. So at the top of the year, I said, you know what, this is my first audition season in New York. I don't want to get sick. And of course, day three, I get sick. I literally had to stand outside for a particular audition and it was freezing cold. And even though I had a scarf and my coat and I was completely wrapped up, your girl got sick. And I had auditions for the rest of that week that I had planned, the week that I got sick, and I pushed through and I still went to those auditions and literally then got more sick. So I basically pulled back and I said, you know what, you need to, you know, work on your health for a second and pull this all together because you can't keep going out here. You will continue to get sick. And so what ended up happening was I started to just aim for audition appointments. And the way I got those appointments was through Actors Access. I submitted for a lot of different jobs and luckily I was having luck. They were coming back and I was getting appointments. And so in February, I got the great news that I was going to be making my off-Broadway debut in Revelation, and I was super excited to be a part of that project. I honestly, guys, didn't expect that to come through. The callback for that show did not go as I imagined it would. I was really, really sick at the callback, not from like the outdoor sickness that I was talking about, but I had a stomach pain that was literally trying to kill me the day of that callback. So literally, I was just so out of it. So for me to book it, I was just so grateful and like, oh my gosh, I couldn't believe that I actually did. So I did Revelation. We started rehearsals in March of 2019. And then, trying to remember all of this in my head. So in March of 2019, we had one rehearsal, and that one rehearsal was like a music rehearsal to get everyone familiar with the music and to send everyone off to go learn it. And so 2 weeks later after that, on April 1st, that's when we started having rehearsals, and we had them basically Monday through Friday. Sometimes we would have a day off or whatever in between, it depended, but we would pretty much have rehearsal every day. And then we opened on, we opened on May 9th, and then we closed on June 9th. It was a pretty good run. It was 5 weekends at the Players Theater in NYC, and so we had 4 shows every weekend to do. This was a really interesting show to work on. I talk about my takeaways from this experience in another video, so if you're interested in that, definitely check that video out. However, overall, this is a really interesting show to work on because Revelation was literally Revelation from start to finish, like the scripture, like from the Bible, the book of the Bible, Revelation. Guys, my camera was rude and cut me off. My card was full, so whoops. Anyway, yeah, so I don't even know what I was really talking about, but I'm gonna try to pick up where I just left off. And so it was a very interesting and like different, new, exciting musical to work on. So it was a great experience being able to do something like that. After Revelation ended, of course, I was like, oh my goodness, I want to book something again. And so I went on my pursuit of auditioning once again, but this time I was a lot more strategic. I was not just jumping up at 4 o'clock in the morning every time. I said, you know what, Kaisha, in order to jump up at four, you have to get rest. Because what was happening before was I was not getting rest, and then I was standing out in the cold, making my immune system way more vulnerable to germs and things like that. So I said, I have to really be strategic. I also forgot to mention that before Revelation started, or as Revelation was starting, I got tonsillitis. And I said, oh my goodness gracious, I had to go to an ENT. They put a camera up my nose and literally down my throat, and they were able to determine that I had tonsillitis. And so I got an antibiotic, and that antibiotic got it right on out. But it was like a little bit of a healing process. So the way I'm describing these different sicknesses and things, I'm not a sickly person. I literally have been trying to, since I moved to New York, have been trying to figure out what my triggers are, because literally I think I have allergies and I'm allergic to something here in this city, because when I go home to DC, I'm fine. And I like don't understand why I have these sneezing, runny nose, all these different things. So it's a journey we're figuring out. Again, I'll make a separate video because health is a huge thing in this industry. So separate video coming soon. Stay tuned for that. After Revelation was finished on June 9th, I really wanted to book another show. I said, I want to do something else. I don't know what I want to do, but I want to do something else. And I kind of got into that rut again about like, man, you know, am I going to book? Am I going to get anything else? I definitely was like, So I decided to start working on my YouTube channel. I said, you know what? I'm not going to just sit around and not do anything. I need to, you know, work on my YouTube channel. Before I tell you guys about my journey with YouTube and getting back into that whole swing of things, I did before Revelation, and kind of like, I guess you could say in the middle of when we were doing rehearsals and about to start performances, I got hired by the American Musical and Dramatic Academy to work in the education and admissions department. And so that was a really, really wonderful thing for me to be able to earn from AMDA after, especially having just gone there. I was really, really blessed and fortunate to get that job. It is the most wonderful survival job that I think any actor can have, to work back at a school where they attended and to give back to that community. So I'm super fortunate and grateful to be working there. So yeah, I got that job, and so this is basically, you know, me working at AMDA, and then now that I'm finished Revelation, me trying to figure out what performance job I'm going to do next. So yeah, I went back to auditioning, and luckily my hours at AMDA are pretty flexible, so I was able to balance both. So I went back to auditioning, looking for things, had a few appointments, had appointments for some bigger roles, some bigger shows, and that was really exciting. So as I'm auditioning, I end up getting an appointment for the Full Monty at Argyle Theater in Babylon Village, and I auditioned for that, you know, like, I don't know, I guess it was probably, oh goodness, maybe July-ish? What month is this? I don't know. Maybe it was August. It might have been August. And I don't hear anything for like a few weeks. So I kind of like in my mind just kind of said, you know what? That's another one you just didn't get. I literally thought I didn't get it. And then I get a phone call like, hey, you booked this. You're going to be in the ensemble. And I said, what? Yes! My regional theater debut! I was so excited. So it was something I was really not expecting. I didn't expect to get it, and I was just blown away when I did. It literally, guys, I was having a tantrum right before I got the phone call. My husband and I were in the apartment. He was like, Kai, come on, let's go to the gym. I have not really been feeling like going to the gym, and he was going to help me and like try to motivate me through my workout, and I just didn't feel like going. I had a whole attitude. I was like, I'm tired. I'm doing all this work, and I'm not getting any results. I suck. Like, I was literally having a pity party, and literally we're walking down the street, and when I tell you I'm walking at a snail's pace because I have such an attitude, like, it was just crazy that I got the phone call literally during this tantrum. And then after I get off the phone, I was like, come on babe, let's go to the gym, I'm in a show, I got to get ready. it's crazy how it happens. Like it was so something I didn't expect. So it was a cool thing to book this show, and it has been such a blast. I made a video about us opening, and I got some behind the scenes, so you guys go ahead and check that out. And you know, at this point, what month is this? We're in September still, so it'll be October soon. We have about 3 months left of the year, and I have booked another show. It is a musical. I am not going to announce it just yet because I don't know if it's okay to announce it. So I'm going to wait before I say anything, but I do have a show that's going to take me all the way through the end of 2019. And I'll give you a hint. It's a Christmas show, and I'm so excited to be doing this. I love Christmas, and I love spreading holiday cheer. Just call me the Holiday Cheermeister. So your girl is really excited to be a part of this production. And again, that'll take me through the end of 2019. So to recap, just to show you how much I've worked as an artist since the time I graduated to now. So I did 2 cabarets and a play. All 3 of those opportunities were unpaid, but all valuable experience. Then I did my off-Broadway debut in Revelation the Musical. I'm currently in the full Monty at Argyle Theater. And then I will be doing another mystery musical that I will announce at a later date through the end of 2019. So professionally, I've booked 3 professional jobs since graduating from AMDA. And to be honest, I think that I am really, really, really proud of myself. I am really, really proud of myself for booking professionally. If you know my story, you know that before going to AMDA, I had 0 musical theater experience. This is a relatively new field for me. And for me to have been able to go to AMDA for, 16, 18 months, whatever it is, and then to be booking professional gigs in New York City, and New York City and beyond, it's unbelievable. It is unbelievable. And I'm so happy right now because I'm watching my friends book. I have friends that are on tour. I have friends that are making their off-Broadway debuts and, you know, doing their own shows. And it's wonderful to watch. And so I just want to bring up one thing that I said in this video. During the times that I was getting frustrated with acting and I was getting frustrated with the fact that I wasn't getting callbacks or that I wasn't booking roles, I literally poured myself into my own creative projects. And that's why I think it's really, really important for actors to have an outlet, something that they can do outside of auditioning to keep their creative juices flowing. Because if you only, I feel like it can be dangerous sometimes to only focus on this. You gotta have something else. And so I'm so thankful for you guys here on YouTube because you guys give me something else to focus on. And it also just, it helps keep me sane. It helps keep me healthy. And so we love being sane. We love being healthy. So we're gonna keep that up. All right, guys, this video is getting really, really long, but I just wanted to give you an idea of how much I work professionally, you know, in the industry after AMDA, and then also to let you guys know what I do as a survival job and, you know, kind of everything in between with podcasts and YouTube. I actually don't think I told you guys what my commitment was to YouTube when I wasn't booking. My commitment was making 2 videos a week. You guys know that I upload on Thursdays and Sundays, so that's been my thing, and now with us being at the end of September, I have been consistent with that goal for 3 months, and I plan to be consistent through the end of the year. We have, like I said, since I have another show, I'm gonna have to be creative on how I get those videos done. However, that is still my plan to be consistent. So yeah, guys, I hope this video wasn't too all over the place, but if it is, you know your girl, I'm all over the place a little bit sometimes. So, you know, it happens. I'm an artist. I'm a creative. What do you want from me, okay? You know, I don't know. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for tuning into this video. If you have any questions or you want to talk to me more about anything specifically that I've said here, please comment below and I'd be happy to chat with you. All right, guys, I'll catch you on the next video. Bye.